الرحمن الرحيم. These questions common in Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board, and Egyptian board. And also you can visit during you are discharging patient from nursery or in your clinic. We'll see our case here. This is new mother asks you about several birthmark on her child. So there is some birthmark and the mother is concerned and she asking you to explain to her about this birthmark. She points out several hypopigmented oval macules over the child trunk and extremities. On the trunk and extremities. So there is hypopigmented, well demarcated macules in the trunk and extremities. So this is a concern of the mother. She noticed this has been present since birth. This is present since birth. And she concerned because she had brother, she had his her brother with the same spots and who she think had growth in his brain. And she think this lesion, there is some link between this lesion and the brain, call it neurocutaneous. So this patient having a skin lesion and she is linked with neurological abnormalities and might having seizure or neurological abnormalities or CNS abnormalities. So the concern of the mother, you have to counsel her this concern that the infant may develop which of the risk conditions. So this baby liable for what? This patient having hypopigmented, well demarcated lesion, if you see here, this is on the trunk and the extremities, looks like ash leaf spots. Ash, لو رمادي, شكل رمادي. Ash leaf, this is hypopigmented macule, well demarcated macule, variable in size, maybe millimeter or centimeters, and actually it's seen prominently, it will be in under ultraviolet light. Ultraviolet light. It will be seen. It will be well seen in ultraviolet light. So this is the concern of the mother. The mother concerned about this hypopigmented macule, or call it ash leaf spots, or ash leaf spots. So you have to inform her. This ash leaf spots might be more commonly associated with neurological abnormalities. It's called neurocutaneous or oculocutaneous syndromes. Neuro, so this baby liable for seizure, maybe intractable seizure or hypsarrhythmia or West syndrome, and also may liable for retinal astrocytomas or retinal abnormalities. Retinal abnormalities, ocular, and also can lead to neurological abnormalities like seizure disorder, learning disabilities, later on psychological abnormalities, and common associated with tuberous sclerosis. Tuberous sclerosis is called phacomatosis. Phacomatosis is, this means neuro-oculocutaneous lesion. Neuro-cutaneous or oculocutaneous lesion. Call it visceral syndrome. This means it will affect the CNS. It's liable for tuberous, it will be in the CNS, and eye, it will be retinal astrocytomas, and also cardiac rhabdomyosarcomas, and also visceral can affect the renal, call it angiomyolipomas, we call it visceral syndrome. So this is the ash leaf. We call it well demarcated hypopigmented area. It may be millimeter or centimeter, can affect in the trunk or the extremities, and also it will be congenital since birth. It can be in the trunk and extremities, and common association tuberous sclerosis. Sometimes it will be associated with nevus depigmentosa and all localized form of the pigmentary mosaicism. The association, call it neuro-oculocutaneous. So ocular, it will be associated with retinal astrocytoma. Retinal astrocytomas, and almost 50% of the cases will develop at least one retinal astrocytoma in one eye. Malignant transformation can occur, but it's very rare. Can be occur, but very rare. And also, it will be neurological tuberous sclerosis. If you see here, this is the tubercles. It will be cortical tubercles located in the parietal and temporal areas. Parietal and temporal areas. Also can affect the subependymal nodule or in the caudocelamic area. It will be, there is tubercles. We call it cortical tubercles or subependymal nodule. Sub in the caudocelamic area. In the caudocelamic area. Cardiac, it will be cardiac rhabdomyomas. Rhabdomyomas. Because we call it visceral syndrome or visceral tumor. Visceral or phocomatosis. Phocomatosis is mean neuro-oculocutaneous syndrome. So there is CNS, it will be tubercles. And the CNS and the patient can present with intractable seizure or hypsarrhythmias. And the ocular would be retinal astrocytomas. And cardiac rhabdomyosarcoma. And renal and liver can lead to angiomyolipomas. It's called visceral tumor. Call it tuberous sclerosis, visceral tumors. So call it neurocutaneous ocular syndrome or phocomatosis. So investigation, you have to do CNS, you have to do imaging studies to rule out tubercles or the CNS or cortical tubercles. You have to do eye fundus examinations and the slit lamps. And also you have to refer to dermatologist for this ash leaf spots and the hypopigmented areas. And you have to do CT and neurological assessment and examination of the family. You have to examine the family because this is autosomal dominant and autosomal dominant trait or with variable penetrance. How to treat this patient? It will be symptomatic treatment based on there is seizure. You have to treat the seizure. Sometimes it will be intractable seizure. Periodic physical examination, because this baby may be adenoma sebaceous, or it will happen after 4 to 7 years of the age. You have to examine this patient for that. And you have to monitor this patient neurologically and cutaneously and ocular. And if he need any CT or MRI or abdominal or cardiac echo examination, you have to do for these patients. So what is the key points of this patient with ash leaf spots or tuberous sclerosis or phocomatosis or visceral syndrome or neuro-oculocutaneous syndrome? This is tuberous sclerosis. It will be infested with hypopigmented oval irregular shaped skin macule, call it ash leaf. And also it will be affected with neurological abnormalities. It will be cerebral sclerotic tubercles. It will be present if you request for CT or MRI. And also this, the common association with this ash leaf spots or tuberous sclerosis, it will be seizure, myoclonic seizure, later on generalized seizure. And at age of 4 to 7 years, if there is adenoma sebaceous, you have to examine this patient and you have to refer to a pediatric dermatologist for such cases. And you have to examine the family members because this disease, it will be autosomal trait with variable penetrance. And also there is new mutation are very common. New mutation is very common. So this ash leaf spots will demarcated hypopigmented area. So you have to examine the patient immediately, neurological assessment for any seizure. And you have to refer to ophthalmologist to rule out any retinal astrocytoma. You have to do echo for rhabdomyosarcoma, and you have to do ultrasound abdomen for the liver and renal angiomyolipomas. You have to rule all visceral tumor, because it's called visceral tumor. You have to screen the patient for any tumor in the brain, in the eye, in the cardiac, in the intrathoracic, or in the renal, or in the liver. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.